In this tutorial, I'm going to cover 6 steps how to create an FK setup, and this can be utilized on anything that requires FK, so a character's arm, leg, or spine, maybe even a tail, or anything that you would use FK for. You can use the knowledge you learn in this tutorial and apply it to that, hopefully. I have timestamped the 6 steps down in the bottom, so if you want to jump ahead you can, but there's some things that we need to check at each stage before we move on to the next that can mess things up, so
but we will jump into Maya now.
Okay, so I have some joints that I've created. I'm not going to go into how you create joints. I have another video for that. If you want to find that, I'll link it. But one thing before we move on to actually creating the FK setup is that you need to make sure that your joints are labeled with your naming convention. I'm going to be naughty and just leave it as joint 1, 2, 3, and 4. And the other thing that we need to check is that as you've created your joints and moved them, you haven't left any rotation values. So you just want to go in and check that. If you
have, once you've got your joints created and you haven't got any rotation values on them, we need to orient them.
So to do this, we're going to select the bottom joint, right click and choose select hierarchy. This is going to select each individual joint, and then we're going to go to display, transform display, local rotation axis. What Maya is now showing us is the orientation of these joints, and we can see that they're not all uniform. So you're going to select the bottom joint again, right click, select hierarchy, and then make sure you're in the rigging menu. You're going to go to skeleton, orient joint, and open the options box. Primary axis is the axis that you want to point down the bone. I'm going to use X, but if you're using this for like a game engine, there'll probably be a specific one that you need to set it to, so best to check. And secondary axis is the axis that we're going to tell Maya we want to point in the direction of this secondary axis world orientation. And I'm going to choose Z axis, and I want Z axis to point forward. So if I look down here, if I want it to point in this direction, that's my x-axis. So Z, point in X, positive, and hit apply. You'll now see that that's orientated. It's worked. We have these joints pointing in the same orientated correctly. The only one that's not worked is the end joint, and that's normal. So to fix that, we select just that joint. In the orient joint options, turn on orient joint to world, and hit apply, and that's now orientated correctly. So we're gonna turn off the local rotation axis, so we're just gonna select the hierarchy, display, transform display, local rotation axis. We have orientated them. Need to do this at this point, because if you get further along and you haven't done it and you have to go back, you basically have to undo your rig.
So next step is to create your controllers. They can be any shape that you want, but for simplicity, I'm going to use a NURBS circle.
Okay, and here's my NURBS circle, and I'm just going to name this joint1_control. Now, we're going to be using offset groups. So before I do anything with this control, I'm going to press Ctrl+G to group it, and then I'm going to name this joint1_control_OS for offset group. Now, what an offset group is going to do is it's going to allow us to move our controller around and reposition it. So, you know, we can come in and position it over here, wherever we need it to. The offset group holds the translate values, and our controller is still set to 0 and 1, meaning that our animators are going to be able to animate with it. So that's why we use offset groups. You could be asking, why don't we just move the controller and then freeze the transformations? Because if we do that, it will also reset the rotation of the controller, and then you won't have the right orientation when you're in object mode. So that's why we're using the offset group. And what we're going to do is we're going to orient this with our joints. And to do this, we are going to select the joint, control click on the offset group,
go to constrain, parent, open the options box, turn off maintain offset, and hit apply. And what that's done is that snapped our offset group to the joint, and it's also snapped our controller. So we're going to delete the parent constraint because it's done its job. And then this isn't quite, just go into our tool settings and make sure we've got object mode on. As you can see, when I've got the control selected, I've got the x-axis pointing down the joint, which is exactly what we want. It's not orientated correctly in terms of the shape. So to do that, what we're going to do is turn off joint selection, right click on the controller and choose control vertex. I'm going to grab all of those and I'm going to edit the shape of this using the control vertices. So I'm going to rotate that 90 degrees and I'm also going to scale it up slightly. And then when I'm done, right click, object mode, and turn back on joint selection. So my controller, just open my channel box, still has all zero values. It is orientated exactly with the joint, meaning that any rotations that we're going to do are going to be correct. And the offset group is holding any rotation and translate values. So that's how you would orient a controller. We're just going to repeat that. So we're going to take the offset group that we've already got, duplicate it, rename it joint 2, and then also rename the controller. And then to orientate it, we're going to select the joint, control select the offset group, constrain parent, maintain offset should be off. Okay, and we can delete that parent constraint. We've now got a second one perfectly aligned with the joint. So let's just repeat that twice more to add joints 3 and 4. So joint, offset group, parent, delete parent constraint, duplicate one more time. And so if you had an arm, you would only be doing this 3 times for the shoulder, elbow, and the wrist. Same for the legs. If you were a spine, you'd have more. So then we select the end controller, the offset group, hit apply, delete. So we have all of the controllers lined up perfectly. Their rotations are correct in terms of the bones and joints. So now what we're going to do is we're going to set up the hierarchy of these FK controls. And we do that using parenting. I'm going to do it visually in the outliner. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take joint 2 control offset group and hold down my middle mouse button, and that allows me to move it in the outliner. I'm going to position my mouse on top of joint 1 control and let go. And now what's happened is I've started to create a hierarchy so that when joint 1 control is moved, it's also going to move my joint 2 control. And then my joint 2, when I move that, it doesn't move anything yet. It doesn't move above it because we're creating an FK hierarchy. So just undo that. So I'm going to take joint 3 offset group onto joint 2 control, and then joint 4 offset group onto joint 3 control. And so now we've set up our FK hierarchy just like that. Okay, it moves down the chain. So now we just need to make it so that the controls control the joint. So to do that, we're going to select our control and our joint, constrain parent. I'm going to turn maintain offset back on, hit apply. Let's just check that that worked. Grab your control, and now it's moving that joint. We need to just do it for the rest of the joint. So really simple, select the parent, then the child, hit apply. Okay, parent, which is going to be the control joint, hit apply. And then for the last one, control joint, hit apply. So we now have our FK setup. Okay.
And this can be applicable to anything that you need to set up in FK. So hopefully this tutorial proves really helpful. You don't need to find a tutorial that says how to set up an FK arm. You can just apply this knowledge to anything that requires FK.